This bone is the radius. A dead giveaway is this nice, flat, round head of the radius. It's the nice, flat, round head of the radius. Pick it up and kind of see how it's rounded. Now, this nice, flat, round head is just proximal to the neck of the radius, the neck. While this bump you see down here, that bump is going to be the radial tuberosity. So it goes head, neck, radial tuberosity. But if you continue down the bone, you get down to this point, that point is going to be the styloid process. The styloid process. Well, since we had a radial notch on the ulna, we should have an ulnar notch on the radius. This smoothish portion right here, that is going to be the ulnar notch. You can see it articulates the ulna, so the head of the radius goes to the radial notch, the head of the ulna goes to the ulnar notch, forming the two bones of your forearm. So this is going to be your radius. We need to figure out, is it a right or a left? Well, we know the head has to be proximal because the head articulates with what? It articulates with the ulna at the radial notch, but it can also be right at the capitulum, right at the capitulum of the humerus. So we have the head proximal. We need to have the styloid process distal, but also lateral. So how do we know if it goes like this on the right side or like this on the left side? What you'll notice is there's a shallow scoop right here. This shallow scoop has to face anterior. That makes this a right radius. Head proximal, styloid process lateral, and this shallow scoop or shallow indent is going to be facing anterior, a right radius.